Countries negotiating a global treaty to curb plastic pollution failed to reach an agreement. The fifth UN Intergovernmental Negotiating Committee between Busan, in Busan, South Korea, was intended to yield a legally binding global treaty. More than 100 nations want to cap plastic production, but a handful of oil producers were prepared only to target plastic waste. The nations then agreed to resume talks on a later date.
So I think we spent 2.5 years sort of going around in circles in these negotiations. And while we are incredibly disappointed that we did not land a meaningful agreement here in Busan, I think the silver lining is that more than 100 countries representing billions of people stood up for the type of treaty that will reduce plastic production, protect human health, and finance the transition that's going to be desperately needed to address the plastic pollution crisis.
Still reeling from recent typhoons, heavy rains brought by the shear line triggered renewed flooding in the Bicol region. In Camarines Norte, several families residing near the Busigon River were evacuated. Some roads were also damaged. In Catanduanes, a province still reeling from Super Typhoon Pepito, several areas in Verac were also flooded. At least 4 landslides also recorded in the town of Bagamanoc. The shear line also affecting parts of the Visayas, including Bataan, Aklan, where residents have resorted to using boats to navigate chest-deep floods. Rescue operations also being carried out in Rojas City, in Capiz. Well, the heavy rains have now claimed several lives in Camarines Sur and Camarines Norte. Let's get an update now on the flooding situation in the province from our correspondent, Jonathan Magistrado. Jonathan, go ahead.
Hi, Carmina. In Camarines Sur, at least 3 people have lost their lives in separate drowning incidents over the weekend. In Ragay Town, a 39-year-old man, Jeremy Moldes, drowned on Saturday while attempting to retrieve his jacket while crossing a train bridge in Barangay Binahian Upper. While in Cabusal Town, 2 senior citizens, Jesse De Los Santos and June Grimpluma, were swept away by their electric tricycle by strong currents on Sunday. Their bodies were found this morning by the water search and rescue team about 50 meters away from the Biyong spillway where the incident happened. Meanwhile, in Camarines Norte, a 52-year-old man, Eliberto Merilla, was killed in a landslide that struck his home in Barangay Anameam in Labo Town Sunday evening. His wife, Mary Ann, sustained head and chest injuries and was admitted to Camarines Norte Provincial Hospital. In Mercedes Town, strong waves capsized at least 5 fishing boats, resulting in the death of one fisherman and injuries to another. A resident of that town who sustained injuries from a collapsed wall is now safe, according to a local disaster official. While the weather has improved in Camarines Norte and Camarines Sur, floodwaters persist in some areas, and residents are urged to remain cautious. Local authorities are monitoring the situation closely and assisting affected communities. Reporting for ANC, Jonathan Maestrado, ABS-CBN News.
Thanks a lot, Jonathan Maestrado. They're joining us on the line. A woman died after being trapped by a collapsed wall in Cebu City following strong rains Sunday night. The 47-year-old victim was with her husband when a nearby stone wall collapsed in their house made of light material. Disaster officials suspect the wall's foundation softened due to the heavy and continuous rains. It took the responders around 5 hours to rescue the husband, who survived the incident. Responders took another 2 hours to extricate the victim, who died in hospital. 4 other families were evacuated following the incident. Back on the line, Annie Perez now on those 2 landslide incidents in Cebu. Annie, over to you.
Yes, that's right, Carmina. Cebu City logged at least 2 landslides on Sunday night and were triggered by the heavy rains that occurred also last night. The first one was at Sitio Lupa, Barangay Busay, where 3 houses were involved. 2 were partially damaged and 1 was already at risk. The barangay council already advised the residents to evacuate, and as of last night, they were offered the barangay hall as temporary shelter while clearing operations were on the way. As of today, we got word from the barangay that the residents already returned to their homes. With the clearance of the Cebu City Disaster Risk Reduction and Management Office while also monitoring the current situation. No one was hurt from the incident. The second landslide was at Happy Valley, Barangay Labangon, where a portion of a riprap collapsed. Authorities said nobody was hurt, but they're assessing if some cars by the car wash in the area were damaged. The Cebu City government is now conducting an assessment to these sites. We talked to the chairman of the City Disaster Risk Reduction and Management Council, Councillor Joel Garganera, and he said that he is going to look into the structural integrity of these structures, and he has asked the Office of the Building Official and the Department of Public Works to conduct their assessment immediately. Apart from landslides, the Colon Street in Cebu City, which is one of the oldest roads and the longest stretch in the city, was inundated by flood due to the rain. The water was knee-deep, which took hours for it to subside, and a lot of commuters were stranded also last night. Aside from Cebu City, Carmina, the town of Bolhoon also experienced flooding, and this prompted local government officials to suspend classes for all levels in public and private schools today. According to Pag-asa Visayas, they issued a strong rainfall advisory for Cebu due to the effects of the shear line. They logged 45.2 millimeters of rainfall last night, which is also equivalent to 226,000 barrels of water poured in just a matter of about 2 hours. And as we speak today, we are now experiencing fair weather here in Cebu. And that's the latest from Central Visayas. Annie Perez, ABS-CBN News.
Thanks a lot, Annie. And let's now get a quick look on the weather from ABS-CBN resident meteorologist Ariel Rojas. Ariel, will we see more gloomy days this week?
Yes, Carmina. State Weather Bureau Pag-asa forecasts up to two tropical cyclones in this country this December, but this week we'll have no weather disturbance. However, scattered rains will persist today due to two weather systems which may cause flooding and landslides in some areas. The weakening northeast monsoon or Amihan will continue to bring light rains over northern Cordillera, Batanes, and Cagayan, but temperatures have not yet dipped significantly so far. Meanwhile, the shear line where the cool and dry Amihan meets the warm and humid easterlies will bring moderate to heavy rains in Isabela, Nueva Vizcaya, Aurora, Calabarzon, Mimaropa, and parts of Bicol region. The shear line is also causing the overcast skies and passing rains here in Metro Manila. Visayas and Mindanao, on the other hand, will be sunny and humid with possible thunderstorms this afternoon, especially in Panay, Negros, Zamboanga Peninsula, Northern Mindanao, Barm, Soxargen, and Davao region. Beginning Tuesday or tomorrow, both the Amihan and shear line will retreat northwards, which means Cordillera and Cagayan Valley will be drenched in heavy rains through Thursday or Friday from the shear line. By weekend, a fresh surge of Amihan will blanket most of Luzon. That's the latest on the weather. This is Ariel Rojas. Back to you, Carmina.
Thanks a lot, Ariel Rojas, there joining us on the line. Here's a look at the areas where local governments have announced the suspension of classes today in expectation of continued bad weather.